Hello students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we are going to learn how to solve word problems of addition and subtraction. But before starting with this video, let me tell you that we have made videos on every chapter of Class 3 Mathematics. We also have interesting worksheets and quizzes on each chapter. You can find all of them on our channel Learning Notebook. Also, you can see a list of all such videos on our website. The link to our website is below in the description box. So let's start and see the first word problem. There are 3, 4, 1, 6 people at a football match. 7, 2, 4 people leave the match. So how many people are left in the stadium? Students, first, always understand the given word problem. So here we are given that 3, 4, 1, 6 people are present at a football match. But then some people, that is 7, 2, 4 people, leave the match. So we have to find how many people are left at the football match. So it means we have to subtract these two numbers. So let's solve this word problem. In a word problem, we always first write the statements. So let's write the statements. People at a football match equals to 3, 4, 1, 6. Next, people who left the match equals to 7, 2, 4. So people left in the stadium equals to 3, 4, 1, 6 minus 7, 2, 4. So let's subtract these two numbers. To subtract these two numbers, first write them in column and then start subtracting them from ones place. 6 minus 4 equals to 2. Now subtract the digits at tens place, but 1 is weaker than 2, so it needs to borrow from hundreds place. So 4 becomes 3 and 1 becomes 11. Now 11 minus 2 equals to 9. Let's move to hundreds place. Again, 3 is weaker than 7, so it will take help from thousands place. So 3 becomes 2 and 3 at hundreds place becomes 13. Now 13 minus 7 equals to 6, and then we have 2 at thousands place. So our answer is 2692. We will write the answer statement. There are 2692 people left in the stadium. Students, do remember to write the answer statement for any word problem. Students, we have separate videos on complete chapter of addition as well as on subtraction for class 3. I'm sure all your doubts related to both these topics would be resolved after watching these comprehensive videos. The link to these videos are below in the description box. Now let's see the next word problem. Mary and her friends are collecting bottles for their recyclable project. They collected 248 bottles in the morning, 388 bottles in the afternoon, and 192 bottles in the evening. How many bottles did they collect in all? So students, let's first understand this word problem. Mary and her friends are collecting some bottles. So they have collected 248 bottles in the morning. Then they collected 388 bottles in afternoon and then 192 bottles in the evening. So here we have to find how many bottles in total they have collected. So it means we have to add these three numbers. So let's solve this word problem. First, as I told you, we have to write the statements. So number of bottles collected in morning equals to 248. Next, number of bottles collected in the afternoon equals to 388. And number of bottles collected in the evening is given as 192. So total number of bottles collected would be the sum of these three numbers. So let's add them. Write them in columns and start adding them from ones place. 8 plus 8 plus 2 equals to 18. So carry 1 to the tens place and 8 comes in the answer. Now add the digits at tens place. 1 carry plus 4 plus 8 plus 9 equals to 22. So carry 2 to the hundreds place and 2 comes in the answer. Now let's add the digits at hundreds place. 2 carry plus 2 plus 3 plus 1 equals to 8. So our answer is 828. Let's write the answer statements. 828 bottles were collected in all. Students, we also have a separate video on complete chapter of division for class 3. This video has lots and lots of examples for your practice. So do watch this video. The link to this video is below in the description box. Now the third word problem is, there were 8,000 bags of rice in Keshav's shop on the first day of the month. By the end of the month, 1,548 bags were left. So how many bags of rice did he sell? So students, in this word problem, we are given with bags of rice on the first day of the month, which are 8,000. Now, during the entire month, Keshav has sold some bags of rice. And then at the end of the month, he is left with 1,548 bags of rice. So, what do we have to find here? We have to find number of bags of rice he sold during the month. So, this is the case of subtraction. Let's first write the statements. Number of bags on the first day of the month equals to 8,000. And number of bags left on the last day equals to 1,548. So number of bags sold equals to 8,000 minus 1,548. So let's subtract these two numbers. So let's first write these numbers in column and start subtracting them from ones place. But 0 is weaker than 8. So it takes the help of 8 at thousands place. So 8 becomes 7, 0 becomes 10. And we keep on borrowing and finally 0 at ones place becomes 10. So 10 minus 8 equals to 2. Now move to tens place. 9 minus 4 equals to 5. Then at hundreds place, 9 minus 5 equals to 4. And then 7 minus 1 equals to 6. So our answer is 6452. Let's write the answer statement. 6,452 rice bags were sold during the month. To learn how to subtract three-digit numbers with and without borrowing, you can refer to our separate video. The link to this video is below in the description box. We also have a separate video on how to subtract four-digit numbers with and without borrowing. So I would recommend you to watch both these videos. Now let's move to next word problem. James had some playing cards. He bought 18 packs of cards having 936 playing cards. Now James had 1742 playing cards with him. So how many cards he had initially? Students, let's first understand this word problem. James already had some playing cards with him. Then he bought more playing cards, which are 936. But do note one thing here, that we are given 18 packs of cards. This number is just given to us for confusion. We don't have to use this number 18 anywhere in solving this word problem. We just have to focus on number of playing cards. So James had already some playing cards and he bought 936 more playing cards. So now he has 1742 playing cards in total with him. So what do we have to find here? We have to find how many cards James had initially. Initially means in the starting. So let's first write the statements for this word problem. Number of playing cards bought by James equals to 936. And now the total number of playing cards with him equals to 1742. So to find number of playing cards with him initially, we will subtract these two numbers. Write these numbers in columns and start subtracting them from 1's place. But 2 is weaker than 6. So 2 borrows from 10's place. So 4 becomes 3 and 2 becomes 12. 12 minus 6 equals to 6. Now move to 10's place. 3 minus 3 equals to 0. And then we will subtract the digits at hundreds place. But 7 is weaker than 9. So 7 borrows from thousands place. So 1 becomes 0 and 7 becomes 17. So 17 minus 9 equals to 8. So our answer is 806. We will write the answer statement. James had 806 playing cards initially. To learn all the concepts related to multiplication for class 3, you can refer to our video on complete chapter of multiplication. The link to this video is below in the description box. Let's move to next word problem. A cricket team scores 534 runs in the first innings and 397 runs in the second innings. So how many runs did they score all together? So here we have given with the score of a cricket team in the first as well as in the second innings. And we have to find total runs scored by them. So it's a clear case of addition. Let's write the statements. Runs scored in the first innings equals to 534. Runs scored in the second innings equals to 397. So to find the total runs scored, we will add these two numbers. To add them, let's write them in columns and then we will start adding them from ones place. 4 plus 7 equals to 11. So carry 1 to the tens place and 1 comes in the answer. Now let's add the digits at tens place. 1 carry plus 3 plus 9 equals to 13. Carry 1 to the hundreds place and 3 comes in the answer. And then we will add the digits at hundreds place. 1 carry plus 5 plus 3 equals to 9. So our answer is 931. Don't forget to write the answer statement. The cricket team scored 931 runs in both the innings. Students, we also have videos on science where we have covered all the chapters of class 3 as well as of class 4. I'm sure all your concepts related to different topics of science would be cleared after watching these videos. So I would recommend you to watch them. You can find them on our channel Learning Notebook. Now let's see the last word problem. There are 438 roses in a rose garden. The gardener plucks out 79 roses and plants another 125 roses. How many roses are there in the garden now? Students, this word problem has two parts. First, we have to find number of roses left in the garden. As the gardener has plucked out some roses. So first let's solve this part. Roses in the rose garden equals to 438. And roses plucked by the gardener equals to 79. So number of roses left in the garden would be 438 minus 79. To subtract these two numbers, first write them in column and then start subtracting them from ones place. But 8 is weaker than 9. So it borrows from tens place. So 3 becomes 2. And 8 becomes 18. 18 minus 9 equals to 9. Now we will subtract the digits at tens place. But 2 is weaker than 7. So 2 borrows from hundreds place. 4 becomes 3 and 2 becomes 12. Now 12 minus 7 equals to 5 and we are left with 3 at hundreds place. So roses left in the garden equals to 359. So now we know roses left in the garden equals to 359. But after this, the gardener, he plants some more roses, which are 125. So it means total roses in the garden now equals to 359 plus 125. So let's add these two numbers. To add these two numbers, we will start from 1's place. 9 plus 5 equals to 14. So write 4 in the answer and 1 gets carried over to 10's place. Now add the digits at 10's place. 1 carry plus 5 plus 2 equals to 8. And then we will add the digits at 100's place. 3 plus 1 equals to 4. So our answer is 484. We will write the answer statement as, there are 484 roses in the garden now. So students, now I am sure you know how to solve the word problems related to addition and subtraction. Now do watch our videos on complete chapter of addition and subtraction as well. And please share my channel and my videos further. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.